Hey guys, welcome back to another episode on How to Hack. And today we'll be discussing about server-side request forgery, and once again we're back to Webcode. So Webcode is our vulnerable web application platform for us to do all of our web application penetration testing on. And in this case, we have server-side request forgery. Alright, so this is the part where a hacker can abuse functionalities in the servers by manipulating and changing configurations, accessing internal resources, and so on. So this is what we call a server-side request forgery. And a lot of these attacks can come from unsanitized user input, right, directly inputting and changing certain data that is being submitted to the URL. Alright, so all these ways are able to let the hackers gain control of the server and run certain instructions without authorized accesses, okay? So here, on lesson number 2, we have an example. So if I click on steal the cheese, alright, it will say over here, right, change the URL to display Jerry. And in this case, of course, it states you fail to steal the cheese. So what we need to do now is actually to go ahead and start up Burp Suite. So let me go ahead and start up Burp Suite. Okay, so I enter Burp Suite over here. And this will begin running Burp Suite in our environment. So I'll go ahead and click on temporary project, click next, and click on start Burp. Okay, so once you do so, right, you have Burp Suite running. Okay, then we can go under the proxy tab and we can click enable. All right, so in this case I'm going to change the bind to port as 123448. Okay, click OK on that. So you have now your proxy intercept is on, and I can go under the web browser again. All right, so you go to the top right corner of your browser, click under menu and click on preferences. So once you're on preferences, scroll all the way down. Okay, scroll all the way down and you can click onto network settings. So once you click on the network settings, select manual proxy configuration, and in my case 127.0.0.1 followed by port 8888. So this will allow Burp Suite to help intercept and look at all this data that's being sent to and fro between the server and the browser. So go ahead and click the OK on that and begin. We're beginning to see all this data traffic coming in and out between the browser and the information. Okay, so going back to the website, I can go ahead and click on steal the cheese now, go back to Burp Suite, and I'm gonna drop this particular get, all right, the second one. And over here, this is the one that we're looking at. So in this case, right, we can look at the post, we can look at the host, we can look at the user agent data that is sent into the web browser. So you can also do certain user agent manipulation, right, that we may cover in subsequent tutorials, alright? And then you have the SF language, you have the encoding, and so on, alright? And in our case, we have the J session ID, alright? So we did a tutorial on that already, and you have all this different cookie information. So over here, what's really interesting is the URL, alright, as part of the post, and we have tom.png. tom.png, and of course, going back to the browser, going back to the website, it says change the URL to display Jerry. So in our case, going back to Burp Suite, we can actually just change Tom to Jerry. Alright, so based on the changes to the URL, I can go ahead and click on forward. So click on forward on Burp Suite, and going back to the browser, it says you rock the SSRF. Alright, so we manage to change the URL to display a different image. Okay, so we were able to capture the data that was supposed to be post into the web server that would give us a return, a result. In this case, we manipulated the data and now we are able to see all of the information inside the system. Alright, so we could also, right, try looking up certain other kind of images, other kind of text files, documents, and be able to post them straight into the web server. Alright, so that's the whole idea of the server-side request forgery. Alright, so going to lesson number 3, alright, it says the following. Change the URL to display the interface configuration with ifconfig.pro. So if you click on run ifconfig, alright, so I can go back here, I can drop all these lessons, so all this is sent all the time into the web application system, alright, to ensure that we have the lesson overview and manual. So quite a lot of them has been sent over already, okay? Alright, so I think I can go ahead and drop all of them. And all I gotta do, right, is to just go ahead, go back to the site, click on change ifconfig, go back to Burp Suite. Okay, so here, we have to follow post webcode SSRF task 2. And right at the bottom, we have the URL once again, right? So images, right, %2, cat.png. All right, so if you go ahead and forward this, all right, then we can drop the rest, and we can go on the web code, and it shows us an image of the cat.png. All right, so in this case, we're going to change it to interface configuration and ifconfig.pro. So I'm going to drop all this information now, and I'm going to go back to web code, click on the command, all right, go back to Burp Suite, okay, and we have the task too. So all I got to do is just change this to HTTP, all right, followed by the two dots, double slash, followed by ifconfig.pro, and see what we get as a result of it. Click ahead and click forward, and we can go on the web code again, and it says over here, you rock the SSRF, and we can see all these details here. All right, we have the forest information and so on and so forth. So all these different data has been pulled in. And of course, if we go to the final lesson, all right, so it's very important for us to be able to not just prevent cross-site request forgery, but also in terms of server-side request forgery, where the hackers could be using your system, your platform, all right, as a launch pad to run all these cyber attacks against other devices or even against internal network devices, which could be a database system, which could be another computer, another network switch, router, and the list goes on. Alright, so once again, I hope you have learned something valuable in today's tutorial. And if you have any questions, feel free to leave a comment below. And I'll try my best to answer any of your queries. And we'll like, share, and subscribe to the channel so that you can be kept abreast of the latest cybersecurity tutorial. Thank you so much once again for watching.